So again, I just kind of wanted to finish making, you know, some points, because I've been so passionate about health all my life. You know, like while I practice some yoga, sorry, it's, I have like so much information, again, like so many things I've been reading, studying, passionate about for decades that I feel like I never was allowed to speak about, to share, to talk about, because I mean, there's just like, you know, nobody to really talk about things with, because because, you know, being healthy, being smart, you know, pushes other people, you know, right up against the system, and you're pushing right up against the system. And so, you know, that's why it's so hard to do it. And if, you know, like me, you know, you're kind of like your issue and the problem is the people around you, you know, who are, you know, not on their side, they're not on your side, you know, you're not going to be very successful, you know, getting people to look at, you know, what they don't want to look at, even if, you know, you're trying to save them from themselves, basically. And so, again, like I'm just watching another video about these California fires, you know, people showing like some shot of light coming from a helicopter. And I've heard, you know, again, like stories of the government experimenting on like soldiers, you know, using human beings for experimental, you know, MK Ultra, all these things. You know, again, I studied and focused on the abusive family system. That was my my passion, abusive relationships. I mean, this stuff is not normal. I mean, like, this is clearly in your face, like, not healthy. And so, you know, I again, like, I used to hear a lot of people say, you know, over the years about, oh, you know, children don't come with instruction manuals. You know, so I'm, you know, like watching this video made me think of, you know, the government using people, you know, experimenting on people. And so again, like the family system, I feel like in so many ways, in many cases, you know, not everyone I'm saying, but like a lot of cases, you know, the same thing, you know, it's like, you know, people bring kids into the world and then figure out like how to be a parent instead of the other way around. Like everything is backwards. You know, like people, children, innocent people who are, you know, who should be raised. I mean, you know, again, if we lived in the same world, value would be getting passed down from one generation to the next. Not, you know, genetic modification of nature. I mean, like I'm just trying to point out all these in your face blatant signs and symptoms that have been around. You know, I could only speak since the, you know, the 70s. That's how, you know, like when I got here in the 60s, but was getting more, you know, older in the 70s. I mean, young in the 70s, but, and so the mentality of, you know, diluted humans, you know, diluted adults, you know, that say like, oh, you know, well, children, you know, they don't come with instruction manuals. I mean, so, I mean, like, what does that say about us as a human race when you need, you know, an instruction manual to be a parent? I mean, you should just like instinctually know how to, you know, if we lived closer to nature, if we were in touch with any kind of real value, you know, people would know how to raise their children. You know, again, but because everybody is, you know, has been conditioned, chose whatever to value fake money rather than things and skimp on real value, you know, like what do we expect to happen? Making statements like, you know, children don't come with an instruction manual, when, you know, I could actually disagree with that, because bookshelves in bookstores are literally filled with books on relationships and parenting and health and mental health and raising children, you know, right. But, you know, it's like, because we just don't live in a healthy system. I mean, it's a sick system. Again, the signs and symptoms that we live in disaster capitalism have been around a long time. I mean, I was definitely noticing it and feeling it all my life, since the early 70s. And so, right, I'm making the point that the family system has become an experiment. I mean, it is the design of this system to break up the family, to destroy the family. And the people are just allowing it. I mean, I just don't understand. I mean, because I had the consciousness. I mean, maybe it was the conditions, you know. I mean, it was so abusive when I was a kid. You know, speaking of which, you know, I lift myself up, I look out the window, and there is what looks like a chemtrail, you know, going outside the window there. You know, all I'm saying is, right, the genetic modification of people. I mean, this dilution, you know, human beings being diluted, you know, immature children just, you know, multiplying, and then using the excuse, you know, like, oh, that they weren't brought up, you know, to just pass the debt, you know, down to you. I mean, it's just in your face. The signs and symptoms are just in our faces. And it was crystal clear to me at a young age. I was pointing it out at a young age, and I mean, you know, it's just clear that, like, you know, no one is on your side. I mean, again, family, neighbors should be on one another's side, should have one another's back. And again, like, I just hope it isn't too late, if people are going to just, like, then at the last minute start scrambling, you know, like, oh, you know, gee, I should have, you know, treated my kids better. I should have loved my spouse better. I just hope it isn't too late, because the sociopaths sure do have a lot of leverage. Again, you know, I know, like, the things that I talk about, make videos about, it's not a common subject. You know, right, like the focus of many people's videos, you know, is on, like, you know, the conspiracies, 9/11, you know, all the large scale things. Well, I mean, again, I lived the small scale things, which got ignored, which is why now we live in large scale things, you know. So that's what happens when people trivialize and discredit, you know, the people who they should be listening to, because exactly, it's a catch-22. It's like, people don't listen to somebody until they're like a somebody, until they're like, they've reached some level of credibility. But how do you get to reach that level of credibility when you're being undermined, you know? So there's my point. If you find any of this information useful, I mean, I've been studying things all my life, you know, since a young age, and it's just exactly the same. People are making the exact same points today on a larger scale, you know, because they didn't experience things in the family system like I did. But there's plenty of people that had it even worse than me, and I make these videos on behalf of the innocent children being sex trafficked and abused all over the world. I mean, they're sacrificed. I mean, there's just no question about that. They're just like, right, done, goodbye, extinct. I mean, I just keep you know, again, like I said, I mean, I've been, you know, studying things, figuring things out, you know, for decades. And I have a lot of information. I mean, I've been holding in for so long and I'm dying to, you know, I mean, like, feel like I could finally, you know, speak about things. God, before I lose my train of thought, which I fear that I just did. You know, I was just thinking about, you know, again, you know, the family system and how, you know, families will just literally and willingly, you know, fight with each other, discredit one another to save the system. And then it led me to thinking about how, like, abuse is literally addictive. I mean, people are, like, literally addicted to abuse. And right, like, that is, like that is debt. I mean, that is, like, literally a disease. It's you know, cancer. It's a psychological, physical cancer when the momentum, you know, it's like the fires in California. I mean, you know, they just continue and gain, like, you know, strength and momentum if they're not, you know, put out. You know, which then led me to think about, hear a lot about, you know, pedophiles, you know, people in jobs, you know, people that actually have jobs. And then during the job, you know, you'll hear that this person was found out to be, like, a pedophile or, you know, whatever, a criminal rapist or whatever they are. And again, like, this is the point that I've been trying to bring out literally for decades. Like, I've actually been trying to talk about things, you know, so that you don't go into the workforce, you know, your abuse can't help but come out. You know, like, I'm trying to talk about this stuff, get people to deal with it all of my life, talk about things, for crying out loud. And all I ever, you know, because, right, like, I felt it being done to me. You grow up in abuse, you know, I mean, I don't want to repeat this stuff. I don't want to, you know, in the family system or out, you know, when you get a job either. But if it's not dealt with, if it isn't, you know, talked about, if many people, enough people don't talk about this stuff and deal with it, that's exactly what happens. You can't not, recreate it. You can't not, repeat it, because it is like pollution. Like, when you're abused, like, you've literally inherited pollution, psychological and emotional pollution. And unless it's cleaned up, unless it's, you know, recovered, like Puerto Rico and the other, you know, there needs to be recovery. You know, people were always telling me, oh, you know, I have to do it by myself. Like, I just have to, like, you know, by myself do this stuff. No, no, no. Everybody has to do it. All people have to do it. Not just, you know, like the person who's inheriting it is actually the last. And yet, you know, like, I'm being that, like, you know, like, I'm like the sole one for cleaning up what I didn't even do. What I basically just inherited. And so, okay, again, here I am, the person trying to do the right thing for decades, you know, starting in the 70s by actually talking about things. You know, by the time, you know, the 80s rolled around, I mean, I was well into reading, studying book after book after book about the dysfunctional abusive family system. Any dysfunctional relationships anywhere, and the beginning of when I, you know, turned to, you know, health and fitness and just doing a lot of, you know, exercising and in order to figure out the math, in order to just do the math. And, you know, because so many people, you know, like, again, like, you're surrounded with this attitude of, like, you know, abuse builds character, or, like, it's good for you, and all of this nonsense. When meanwhile, it's like, so through exercise, it was clear that, like, no, you know, up to a certain point of efforting and challenge is when you... you grow and you get strong. Past that point, you're just being abused and broken down. And so the real reason why you're inheriting this stuff is because those before you, they didn't do their rightful amount of fitness, their rightful amount of growing and developing. And so, you know, like, because we live in a debt-based system, you know, they're passing it down to you. So, you know, like, right, like, you know, they're not passing down to you health by telling, you know, by having this attitude, you know, that abuse is somehow, you know, good for you, or, you know, you can just magically recover, you know, on your own, or just even get over these things on your own, without a community effort, without family and community effort, and everyone working together, like now they're forced to be doing in Puerto Rico. Because instead of getting, I mean, again, Puerto Rico and the other places that are devastated are another clear example of what I've been saying since the 70s on a larger scale. Because exactly, like, instead of just being helped when you're dealing with a disaster or some kind of a crisis, you get loans instead, loans at interest, which is what those around me did at a young age. I mean, again, like, I'm speaking about the family system, illustrating, you know, family, relatives, community. It's all just a scaled down version of what more people are speaking about, you know, today. I've mentioned things like the Flint water crisis, another perfect larger example of what I was sharing about the family system. Sorry, I just want to, you know, decades ago. I mean, it's exactly the same, only on a larger scale. Sorry, I think I tipped it the wrong direction. And now, instead of, you know, the family system being abusive, you have an abusive governor poisoning a whole city. I mean, this is, like, outrageous. You know, and it's because, you know, it's, again, it's because people just learn to live with clear signs and symptoms that there's something is wrong. And they just keep bailing out and making excuses for the people in power instead of, you know, and right, like, and allowing their life and their health, you know, to get lower and lower and lower. And that's what, you know, that's what they tried to teach me. And I fought, you know, I just was in, you know, a position for whatever reason, you know, to stand up and fight back. It could have been due to the fact that it was a single parent that was the abuser, you know, like the mother and not the father, you know. I don't know. But all I know is I had the ability to fight back. And I mean, again, like, I'm just making these points just to illustrate the math, the facts, and the evidence. And again, sorry, I just, like, almost lost my train of thought again. The point that I was gonna make was that I was being taught at a young age that instead of, you know, parents, relatives, neighbors, like, they're supposed to be stepping up to the plate for you. And instead, everyone is teaching me, my health has to go like this. I'm not allowed, like, I gotta lower the bar on my life. This is not family. This is not relatives. This is not neighbors. These are enemies. That is the basic fact and evidence. Real family, real neighbors have your back. They're on your side. They fight for their children. They don't tell you, you just have to live with trauma. You just have to be a slave. You know, never mind living to your full potential. You know, just get a job. You know, I mean, like, I don't get it. Like, this stuff was so clear. You know, when I was growing up in the 70s, I mean, it was just normal to everybody else. And I'm over there like I'm living in the Twilight Zone. Like, what the hell? Like, you're just literally surrounded by everybody who was just in on it. And it was so clear, you know, because, you know, my body just knew the truth. I mean, your body is feeling all of this trauma, all of this, the adverse effects on your health, and yet it's normal. So again, you know, it's not a surprise that this is the country that we're living in today. This is, you know, this is what people created. If people find, again, like any of this information, because it's all true. Everything I'm saying is true. It's what I lived. It's just a scaled down version of what people are speaking about today. You know, subscribe, share, let's come together. I got plenty of information. I mean, fitness is my passion. I would love to, you know, to teach things to people. Maybe we could have a mass Skype, you know, class, just practicing, you know, coming together. I mean, I've been like literally trying to get people to come together as families and communities since the 70s. And nobody was interested. And I was criminalized and guilted and, like, you know, put into like a psychological prison, you know, for being healthy, for trying to get people to live to their full potential. Go figure. You know, again, I just keep thinking of more and more points, you know, to make. I apologize if the video is, like, you know, getting longer. You know, but again, like, one of the points that I wanted to make, and that is a point of yoga practice, is that the point of yoga practice is to go into the darkness, is to resist, like, to go into and bring light, you know, into the dark places. You know, the body, this is just a subsystem of the larger system. I'm trying not to lose my train of thought. So the whole point of a yoga practice is to, you know, to breathe, to be present, to move into your body, to literally occupy your own body and evict the sociopaths, the lies, the false beliefs, whoever else has occupied your body, evicted you, the real you, out of it and moved in. Because most people, you know, again, I'm not saying everyone, but, you know, most people don't get to grow up and be their, you know, who they're supposed to be. You know, your body is just being used. You don't get to even inhabit your own body. You know, again, like, this is why, you know, bear with me, please, because, you know, I'm trying not to lose my train of thought, but, like, so many thoughts come to me. The Girl Scouts posted something on Twitter the other day about, you know, consent. They were talking about, the article talked about, you know, how little girls, I guess, you know, I guess could be boys too, who, you know, during the holidays, oh, you know, like, you know, go kiss so-and-so, go give so-and-so, you know, the parents are telling their children, you know, go hug or kiss so-and-so adult, you know, they brought you a gift for the holidays, you know, go hug them, go kiss them, and the child, like, has no say, like, the article, the point of the article is, like, you know, this has been the point I've been trying to, you know, bring out for decades. Like, you don't even get to own your own body. You know, they're being used. You know, the parent is just like, yeah, go give aunt or uncle so-and-so a hug or a kiss. Like, you know, whether you want to or not, whether it feels right or not, you know, or, I mean, you know, whatever, you know. And so, like, that's just kind of like the beginning of how children, most children are taught. You know, not, you know, like it's literally the exact opposite of parenting. It's literally the exact opposite of cultivating another human being. The whole point of reproducing is to cultivate another human being, like planting a tree, you know, to be on their own. Think for themselves, you know, to cut the cord and be your own person. And, it, you know, and again, like, these blatant signs and symptoms, this sickness, this backwards way that nature works, way that people have just adopted like it's normal, is so unbelievably, like, in your face. It's like, it astonishes me that most people just can't see it. And again, because I felt myself being robbed so early. And I, you know, I did my best to fight back at, like, as much as I could and turn to fitness with a vengeance, you know, to try to recover and repair my health. You know, so again, most people, like, the point of yoga practice is to take your body back. So, you know, the reason why, you know, people, you know, can't do certain things like touch their toes or... you know, is because, like, they're literally cut off from their own bodies. You know, their body, certain parts of the body, whether it's a seated forward bend like this, you know, so the whole point would be, you know, if this is how far you can bend, okay, so this is the present moment. Being present and gradually by cultivating the present moment, you know, not by forcing, but, you know, again, at this late stage of the game, you know, people are going to be forced, like the people in Flint were forced, like Puerto Rico is forced, you know. So, I mean, it would be nice if you could do things without force, but I don't know. At this late stage of the game, I don't know about the whole forcing part because, I mean, you know, the whole point is to do things with nature, to cultivate, to set the stage so that nature can then do it, you know, and without force. But, I mean, certain things need to be forced. I mean, you know, people need to be forced. I mean, that's why people have heart attacks because the body is like by force. Letting, you know, the person know, you know, you've been screwing me for decades now. So now you are like forced to either take better care of me, exercise and eat right, or you're out of here. Again, I'm just trying to resume my original train of thought about fitness, which... And the way that nature works and how we've devastated it for decades and decades is to you know, to move into the darkness. It's like most people, I mean, don't realize the way to healing is through the illness. I mean, the illness and the injury literally have the clues and the answer to what the healing is. And so when we see... I'm trying to think of a good word. When we see, like, sort of undesirable people you know, most people just like will shun people. I mean, like, you know, like I'm a fan of psych. It's been my passion my whole life. Because one thing that I really fear, you know, again, is that if people couldn't raise and love people and treat them good when they were at healthy, innocent children, what is gonna, like what are people gonna do now that we have older, traumatized people? I mean, if we couldn't even love and raise people when they were innocent, healthy children, and we abused them or treated them like shit or passed down our psychological pollution to them, then what are we going to do with all of the traumatized adults walking around? I mean, like I was saying before, I was criminalized for trying to point things out and say to people, you know, like, let's deal with things, talk about abuse, let's turn things around, let's deal with the dysfunctional relationships, let's address the abusive relationship issue, the abusive family system, so that people don't go out into their jobs and then, because they were abused, you know, now they're going to abuse some child. Now they're going to abuse maybe a coworker and have that abuse be leaking out. It has no choice but to do that if we live in a society that doesn't address these issues. You know, that just keeps going and chugging out. The fake economy, the fake monetary system just keeps chugging along that is clearly detached from the real economy, you know, called health. I mean, like, I don't get it. I mean, it's like so obvious that the fake economy is detached from the real economy. It's so clear. And yet every day, the fake economy, people just keep it going every single day. And so again, like the point of yoga practice, you know, because people get cut off from themselves at young ages. They're not allowed to feel this. They're not, you're not allowed to be smart and healthy. They get cut off, they get shamed. People are conditioned to not feel things, to literally strangle healthy, normal, vibrant emotions inside of themselves. And so the whole point of yoga practice is to let them back in. The reason the sociopaths, you know, have all the leverage is because they've stolen it from the people. Sorry, let me just take a couple of breaths here. So the breath is the present moment. You're going into and retrieving the parts of yourself that were cut off. You know, taking the breath, you know, in yoga practice, they call it prana, which is the life force, into the darkness. You're taking the light into the dark places inside of your body so that you can just integrate your own parts back to yourself so that all of your energy is working for you and not at your expense. I mean, I just, this is so basic. I don't see, you know, how, I mean, this is not complicated, it's not witchcraft, you know, it's none of these things. It's basic math. Your body is just a scaled down system of the larger. And so this is what I'm saying. It's like, all you got to do is look at the larger system that we're living in and how the few have the most. So again, if my body, you know, functioned in a way where, like one part of my body took everything for itself at the expense of the rest of the body, it's not hard to figure out what would happen. So again, that's just a large scale version of the, you know, and the family system is another scale all the way down, you know, to this scale. And so, again, taking, you know, the breath, the light with you into the darkness, you know, so you could feel what you really feel, so you could, you know, just again, like retrieve your real self, expand, you know, like the people are the ones that need to be expanding. It's the people that need to be stretching, not the corporations, not the bankers. These people have overreached way, way beyond what is, you know, sane and healthy. And yet the people, they don't even get to grow to their full potential. I mean, like the people are literally having the life sucked out of them to feed the sociopaths. People literally bring children into the world and then teach them that. That's what they, again, they tried to do to me. That I had to sacrifice myself and bail out the abuser. And like that I wasn't even entitled to a life. Excuse me. So I think of, and I've always thought of yoga practice as like doing CPR on yourself. You're like literally resuscitating yourself and integrating and taking back all of your parts. I mean, again, the sociopaths have so much leverage and power because we have been taught to some people, you know, to donate. Like, that's why people, they don't get angry. It's like, oh, you're not allowed to be angry. Like, you're not allowed to be powerful. Oh, because, right, because we, you know, because we're so busy being conditioned that we have to donate that part of ourselves to the psychos that now have all of this power and are using it against us. So the whole point of yoga practice is to take that power back so that they, and so it can't be, if everybody integrated all of their healthy self, their healthy parts, instead of it being cut off, and then people expend so much energy kind of, you know, strangling their own self, their own vital selves, you know, I mean, whatever it is, whether it's, you know, joy, you know, pleasure, sexuality, fear, you know, anger, power. I mean, every, you know, just like the body has so many physical parts, muscles, ligaments, tendons, we also have different emotional parts, a variety of healthy emotional parts that we should all be allowed to feel. And yet most people are not allowed to feel all of what, you know, of them, of what they feel in it to a healthy degree. People are afraid if they feel even this much of their anger, then they're going to fall into their anger and it's going to take them over. And so people just strangle it inside of themselves out of deathly fear. But right, because we're not taught to feel our healthy anger. We're not taught to have healthy sexuality, which is why you got pedophiles and child sex trafficking and, you know, because we're constantly destroying nature and health for money. I mean, again, like I'm teaching this stuff to myself for decades, but I didn't know it was really going to be that bad. Like I didn't think that teaching this or, you know, knowing this was, I don't know, that radical or that much of a crime. I mean, I thought like, I don't know, most people knew this stuff or, you know, whether I was so conditioned myself to have like, you know, no value because I have like nobody on my side. So, you know, you're taught like not to have any
credit or feel that anything that you know has any value at all. I mean, you know, again, like I have like nobody on my side. I'm like teaching this stuff to myself my whole life. I mean, this is what family should be teaching. This is what neighbors, relatives, community should be cultivating, should be passing down. And instead, I got to teach this stuff to myself and hope that I'm not, you know, criminalized for doing so. But yet at the same time, you're not being supported. I mean, people certainly were not lining up. You know, again, like only certain people, you know, like, you know, can teach yoga at a certain level if they're privileged enough, if they weren't, you know, if it's too threatening, if, you know, if the things that you say are too threatening to, you know, and right, and it's the people that are growing up and dealing with the more challenging situations, you know, are the people that kind of need to be heard from the most, and yet they're heard from the least. You know, we hear a lot from, you know, people that are just in situations where they're in a position to say things or share things. You know, the point that I wanted to make was the people that we need to hear from the most, we don't get to hear from. Because people are so busy seeing people as discarded rather than saying, you know, like, why is this person like that? What kind of a country are we living in that created this person, you know, to be that way? Again, the injury, the illness, the disease is what can teach you what the cure is. And so, you know, when we look at discarded people like, oh, you know, like we discredit people that we should be integrating. I think that might be a good place to end. What makes me feel like we are doomed is because people don't listen to other people unless they're seen with some kind of credibility. I mean, they were just talking about it on Democracy Now! Or something like before Thanksgiving with the Me Too hashtag. And sorry, I forget the woman's name, Burke, I believe her last name is, talking about the Me Too and you know, the celebrities coming out about sexual harassment and things like that. And she even said, I mean, if it takes celebrities being, you know, like, see, that's what I'm saying. Like, if it's not somebody credible saying things, then we don't listen. Like, we just, you know, continue to keep, you know, reproducing more and more people to just have, like, no credibility and to just be treated like, you know, there is no garbage. There's no such thing as nature. You know, so again, the point of yoga practice, I apologize, I don't really mean to, you know, have these videos go on and on, but it's just, there's so many points, there's so much evidence. I mean, you know, people think of destroying the environment, destroying the, you know, the climate and climate change and things like that as the only way that we're destroying nature. People don't see in relationships and the way that people relate to one another, the breakdown of the family system, the fact that children are raising, you know, parents instead of the other way around. That is the destruction of nature. That, you know, the way your body works, the way health and fitness work. You know, when you see someone in need, you help them. It's backward to criminal psycho sociopaths and abuse the innocent. You know, again, I was just watching Jeremy Scahill from The Intercept, you know, talking about the crisis in Yemen and how it's not on every news. Why isn't it on every news outlet? I mean, these people are being exterminated. Again, the mass, you know, I was talking about it on a scale down. Now it's,
It's massive. It's like this country, the people running this country, the corporations, the banks, the military industrial complex, these people are psychos. And they're literally killing the most vulnerable are the ones that are screwed the most. And that is not the way nature, health, and fitness function. It's the exact opposite. Vulnerable people, children, the poor, the elderly, the ill, they deserve help. And the psychos at the top have, the people have allowed to get all of this momentum, have literally turned nature and fitness inside out, upside down, backwards, twisted, genetically modified, spun, like that you can't even imagine. And I mean, again, like, it, what scares me is that it's like such a catch-22 that I experienced this at a young age. It was like the very people that are supposed to be raising you, instilling, you know, giving you the reinforcement, you know, so that you do have credibility, so that you can be somewhere and then be taken seriously. And, you know, I mean, that needs to be instilled in you by someone, or how else do you get there? So that's what I'm saying. Like the vulnerable who nobody was ever there for because you're so busy being undermined, instead will never be able to reach a place of credibility because everybody's so busy, you know, right, just listening to people that are in a position to be saying things. Well, what happens to those people who are not in a position to be saying things? That who are having and experiencing it worse and need to be heard from even more. So we listen to Jeremy Scahill saying it about the people in Yemen, because the people in Yemen are not in a position to be getting their voices out. I mean, I was trying to get my voice out at a young age, but I was surrounded by the very people that were undermining me. I mean, I didn't know where to find somebody that was actually going to, you know, help me to lift myself and raise myself up. And so if we don't start helping people, helping the vulnerable, listening to the people that we would normally consider like not credible, then those people are just going to be sacrificed. That's it. And, you know, and again, nature doesn't make any garbage. So if we're just going to treat the people, you know, certain people like, right, you know, you're just the experiment, you're just the lab experiment while I'm learning how to be a human being, like children are the lab experiment while, you know, while their parents are like not even trying to learn how to be parents because they don't even learn. They see that they're doing something wrong, but yet they just continue to do it over and over and over again. That was my experience. And so, again, like, this is what we're living with on a mass scale. It's pretty bad. It's pretty bad. So again, just a point about, you know, basic math. I mean, life is all about basic math. Again, the facts and the evidence that people need to exercise their relationship with, you know, to make it just maybe a little bit more difficult for the sociopaths, you know, to pull the wool over the people's eyes. And again, if parents are undermining children rather than, you know, like the Girl Scout post, you know, teaching people to be their own person, you know, instead of, you know, just ordering them and using their bodies, like, you know, right, like they're for the parent, you know, to just use. So again, the point I wanted to make here is, again, apologies. I wanted to say something about, you know, debt, in that we're living in a world where, I mean, again, this is my experience. That's you know, I could only share my experiences. I experience backwards, upside down things where, again, the person who's abused is the one that is being told to do debt forgiveness. All my life, the poor abuser, When again, it should be the other way around. The one who's abused is the one, you know, just like Puerto Rico, innocent people put wrongfully, you know, into this debt, you know, or Greece, you know, is another example. You got innocent people being made to be the criminals, being made to put in an illegitimate debt, you know, me, and, you know, and all my life, people are saying to me, like, oh, forgive, oh, you know, the poor abuser. So again, it's like completely backwards, where it's the abused, the one who rightfully deserves their wrong to be made right, deserves justice, deserves compensation, which never comes in 4+ decades. And yet I'm the one being told to this day by people who I had to stay, you know, distance myself from, you know, oh, forgive, oh, you know, the poor abuser, or, oh, you know, oh, the abusers are dead, you know, whatever it is. But no, actually, sorry, the abusers are not dead. There's plenty of abusers. There's plenty of abusers in power. The family system was just one example. People around, you know, were just one example. I mean, again, the facts are the facts, you know. People around me were the enemy. I mean, it's like literally nobody there for people, innocent people. This is how people stay in debt, like their entire lives. You know, I mean, it's normal for people, you know, just trying to get like to live at a healthy level, you know, to be in debt instead, while the sociopaths keep having more and more overreach, while, you know, if you reach and you're healthy, like you're a criminal. So again, you know, yoga practice is all about just being healthy. People have a right to live to your full potential, to reach your healthy amount of reach, so that the psychos can't have more overreach. I never went to graduate school like I wanted to, because I said, I'm not getting into debt. It's a trap. If you have to get into debt to do anything. And again, people live like this stuff is normal. The average people just trying to reach their healthy potential and do something so criminal, like try to go to graduate school, have to go into debt. Is there anybody besides me that sees something is wrong with this? Where people just trying to live are like literally trapped and forced to be in debt? Why don't the people just put their damn foot down and say fucking goddamn no, 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 and refuse to go to these schools, and unless you can, you know, have your education like funded, you know? I mean, it's ridiculous, you know, for people, you know, just trying to reach their full potential to be in debt. This, again, just like Puerto Rico, we got to be turning this stuff around. They owe us. We don't owe them. We should not be paying them. Having to get into debt to go to graduate school or any kind of school, again, is just a larger version of the abusive family system. You know, I mean, you know, people should have a right to live and have a life and grow to be healthy instead of the corporations and the bankers being and spreading and growing to such large extents, which again, I'm gonna hold the people accountable because it's the people who are the ones that did it. It's the people that make these corporations cancer, that allow them, work for them, help them to keep growing to such like engorged, like a tick that just, you know, is gonna explode. It's the people that did it. The people have done it at their own expense. If people studied what healthy relationships look like, you know, read some books about, you know, a healthy family system and what it functions like, and then take that and expand it to the larger, they would know that working for a company and helping that company get so big that it turns around and then screws you, you would have known that had you studied books about the abusive family system. Because I've been reading it and studying it for decades, but nobody's interested. And this is, you know, this is why we're living in this wonderful system today. To yourself, give the credit, give the power to the people around you. Empower your children, empower the people around you, your family. Stop empowering the sociopaths. Take back, take from the sociopaths, give to the freaking, to the people around you. I mean, that is sanity. That is health and fitness. That's how health grows and goes. You know, we got to stop with this diseased cancer mentality and start turning things around, or we're finished. It's taking a long time to speak out about this stuff because every time I tried, I was always the one to be shamed, you know, to be ridiculed, to be made to feel like, you know, like there was something wrong with me, you know, if you need, you know, a healthy family when you're, you know, a young person. Like, so again, you know, when you're young and you actually need, according to nature, you know, you need healthy people to be there for you, you know, at an early age, you know, or you're not healthy. And yet people, anytime I tried, you know, to voice it, to say, you know, my health is being harmed, you know, I have no eyelashes for years in elementary school, you know, due to like being so stressed, you know. And yet, right, like people, so, you know, so when you need, when nature demands that you need healthy people, healthy leaders to be there for you when you're young, people are over there shaming me. I was like shamed all my life. All I ever tried to do was talk about the abusive family system, abusive relationships, and their consequences on your health. And all I was made to do was feel shamed, you know, as if it's normal to just be a slave and just, you know, you're just supposed to grow to just be a slave and have a job anyway, you know. And yet, you know, here we are now today with, you know, adults complaining that the government isn't taking care of them. The government isn't doing what it's supposed to do. For so, you know, for people that are supposed to be grown-ups, you know. So it's like, so let me get this straight. When you're a kid and you, you know, right, like, you know, you actually do need healthy people there teaching you things, being a role model so that you can, you know, grow up to be a fairly healthy person. And yet, I'm shamed for calling that out and admitting that you need that at a young age. And yet today, right, like adult people are allowed to complain that their government has sold them out to corporate profit. The very corporations that the people made to be as big as they are. I mean, this is insanity. So again, like, you know, it had people, had the real leaders, the healthy leaders, you know, raising them when they were a kid, that's the whole point. Then you wouldn't need it later in life. You're not supposed to need it. You're supposed to have leaders, healthy authority people raising you to be on your own so that you don't need them anymore. So that the cord gets cut and you're able to live and function, you know, on your own. That's the way that nature works. So again, like, not only is it, you know, that we have dysfunctional abusive families because the whole country and the government is dysfunctional. Adults are not supposed to need people in power over them. You're supposed to be raised and be on your own. That's how nature functions. That's how health functions. And yet, you know, right, like had people had the healthy relationships, leaders that they should have had raising them properly, raising you to your full potential so that you could be on your own, then, like, that, exactly, government would, like, literally be obsolete. I don't know, a couple of years ago, you know, when people, I was at protests for, you know, against police brutality, people had a sign saying, you know, healthy communities makes policing obsolete. You know, thank you, again, all these decades later, for making the point that I was trying to make in the 70s. You know, healthy families, healthy communities makes the system obsolete. Guess what? That's why they want to get rid of it. That's why they want to get rid of the family system. You know, like, that's why the family system was dysfunctional and abusive. Making children, you know, dependent, you know, on the family system, you know, making me the criminal for wanting people to do their job and raise me right so that I could be on my way and not need them. And instead I'm being, everything's being turned around where I'm being trained to, you know, to raise and be there for, you know, to take care of, emotionally take care of and feel responsible for the abusive parent instead of the other way around. It's all just the micro of the macro that I got shamed for saying, like, all my life. And now everybody, a lot of people are saying it on a mass scale. So again, this is how we've destroyed nature. This is how we've destroyed health and fitness. Just moving close to learning about health, basic health, basic mental and emotional health that I knew was a taboo. I knew, again, like, I'm you know, I'm like committing suicide by trying to talk about emotional and mental health all my life because I could clearly feel the taboo that it was, but I didn't care because talking about this stuff was no different than just going to the gym. Just like being physically fit, your mental and emotional health is exactly the same. You gotta stay fit. And yet it was a taboo subject to be talking about for decades and decades. And this is the result. This is the consequences of people just not being healthy, not studying health, not learning about basic health, basic relationship skills. We need, again, I mean, mirroring techniques, active listening, cultivating healthy relationships. If we don't start doing it, I mean, I don't know, leave in the comments if anybody is interested in doing, whether it's, you know, Skype calls, like, you know, mass Skype calls, because I don't know, like, we're like really in serious trouble. Again, if you find anything of value in these videos, please share, subscribe. A few FRNs, you know, at least for now. I mean, I should have a link for Bitcoin. I do have a blockchain for Bitcoin,
but
thank you, and please share.